Hi, everyone. This is Joanna, and I wanted to thank you all so much for your understanding and kind words during this difficult time. So I wanted to say that with the loss of my friend, I deeply, deeply appreciate it. So I wanted to say thank you very much. So let's go ahead and get on with the readings. And this is for the week of January 18th through the 24th. All right. Thanks again. Bye. Hi, Scorpio. This is your reading. And just remember, if this doesn't resonate, to watch your moon and or rising sign. And if you would like a reading with me, I do personal video readings, and I send you the links. And then I also offer both Skype and phone readings. And you can reach me at moonwatertarot.com. That's my website. Okay, so let me focus on here for you, Scorpio. January 18th. What are the messages? January 18th, Scorpio. What are the messages, the main messages for Scorpio, for those watching? Scorpio. Okay, let's take a look here. All right, so we have the Wheel of Fortune in reverse, the Hanged Man, and the Six of Pentacles. Okay. So let me move the camera here. All right, Scorpio. Very interesting. So we have the Wheel of Fortune and the Hanged Man here. And I'm just, one thing that I am picking up is I feel that there is an end of a cycle. Like there is something that is just trying to, I don't know, it's almost like it's trying to drop. It's trying to let go. I don't know if this is a feeling like, it's, how do I explain this feeling? It's almost like going from the dark into the light. I feel like timing in the week of 18th is going to be very important. Something karmic is very much been playing out and will have the opportunity, if you take a look at it in the week of 18th, to kind of let go of it. I feel, though, that this may play out longer than the week of 18th through the 24th. But I feel that there's a need, especially with the Wheel of Fortune and here with the retrograde. It's just like you're almost there, but not quite. But this is very much, with the Hanged Man, I'm getting like hanging on to the past. There is a need to let go. And I think if you look at things from a different perspective, especially with the Hanged Man here, that things can change. And for some of you, it definitely is going to change. It's like your time is coming or has come, but it's been such a slow process. I feel like I'm moving, like this wheel is like to tr- like, you know, how do I want to say this? To get, I'm hearing like, jump back on the wheel or jump back on the horse. That's how I'm feeling it. You know, I just feel like there have been strike after strike after strike, but now the wheel is going to, things are going to turn around. This has been, it's been a slow time coming. I don't know why I'm getting that. I don't know if I'm saying that right. But I feel like, you know, there's a reversal of fortune. And actually, that was a movie, I think, with Jeremy Irons, and based on a true story, reversals of fortune. I don't know why I was led to say that. But, you know, obviously what comes up must go down. But I feel like timing is going to be important. I think I already said that. And knowledge is key. There is something to be learned and to be looked at and examined from the past, and then let it go. Let it go. Don't hang on to it, because it's, you know, especially here with the Hanged Man, I'm feeling like there's possibly been some delays in things moving forward. Now, what I'm also picking up is that I feel that by giving on to, or giving to others, especially with this beautiful card here, the Six of Pentacles, that you are going to grow and give to yourself at the same time. So this is very much by helping others, you're helping yourself. What maybe you have lost, you will learn and gain from. It's almost like your life lessons, you will turn around and share those with others. So it's almost like coming full circle. I'm almost viewing this as if at one point you were here, but now things are turning around so that you're positioning yourself up here. So whereas maybe you needed help and guidance from others, you are now learned a lot and are helping and guiding others. It's like everything's coming full circle, which makes so much sense with the retrograde, because this is kind of lack of movement. It's lack of, you know, some of you may have very much been trying to let go of the past, but I feel like you really have to look at it and really examine it in order to let it go. So there's something that you need that would help you is by doing something differently. So I don't know if it's, you know, you may feel like your hands are tied or there's only so much you can do. But I feel that by looking at things from a whole different perspective, because I feel like some of you feel like you were, you know, I'm getting the word screwed over or stabbed in the back, or you feel like you were taken advantage of. So I feel, though, and especially with these two major arcanas, that you're still going through this cycle, but I feel as if it is a turning around for quite a few of you. And the more that you take the time and look at it and really do almost, I don't know, I get letting go. Let go. Maybe some of you, what I'm hearing is this. Maybe some of you have been examining it too much. So like you've examined it. I'm sorry about the noise in the background on Nicholas's playing with a bag there, but maybe some of you have been doing so much examination that it has gotten you stuck, and all you need is to let it go. Let go, let God or whatever your religious or beliefs are, just let go and turn it over to a higher power or turn it over to your angels. And when it comes back in, or that feeling or that energy, just give it back. Give it back with love and send it off to the universe so that you empower yourself. You now see the light and move forward. Because sometimes when we pay close attention so much, to the details, that we get stuck in this cycle. Knowledge is key, but then once we learn what we need to learn, don't hang on to it. So I feel like you're in the process of doing this. Now, everybody's going to be different. I feel like some people have been going through this for a long time, and it's like, please let it be over. And then I feel like for some of you, you're maybe midway through the process, and and some of you are here. You've already gone through this, and some of you are just getting here. The Six of Pentacles, where now you have the enlightenment and the empowerment to give, and you feel more balanced, where you felt imbalance, the hangman and the wheel of fortune. Things are out of balance. What has been out of balance now becomes balance in your life. But I feel that there is still, for some of you, either reflection or looking at things differently, because not all of you have been spending too much time looking at the details. Okay. Some of you may not have done this step at all. And I feel like if you skip from here to here, you're going to end up back here again. Or, if you go from here to here, you're going to end up here. It's just every situation is going to be different, but you do have the opportunity. It is coming up if it has not arrived yet. And some of this, like I said, may play out even further than January to February. I've been saying this, for quite a few signs, and I almost feel like I should have done a 2-week reading, because, and maybe it's with the retrograde, I just feel like these energies for some of you are going to be more long lasting. And I've said that for quite a few signs, but it's getting back on your feet, getting back in the chair, what in the driver's seat. That's what I wanted to say. So anyway, I feel a forward movement coming in, a new beginning. The 10 is the end of the cycle, and it reduces down to a 1. And by doing these steps, you will get here. Out of imbalancement will come balance. So very much, I think a beautiful reading. I'm also getting too that make sure that you take care of yourself. Because I'm getting like, I don't know if somebody is not taking their medication, like you're taking things sporadically, and it could be affecting you or your health. Or maybe there's a need, like for vitamins. I don't know. I'm getting like this need for replenishment. Shed what's not working, embrace what is. All right. Okay, Scorpio. So if you would like a private reading with me, please go to my website, which is moonwatertarot.com. Thank you so much for watching, and have a beautiful week. All right, talk to you soon. Bye.